All right, so 2.6 talks about continuity. So can somebody tell me what a continuous function is? Without looking at the calc definition.
A function that doesn't have any poles or asymptotes.
So a function could have an asymptote and be continuous.
On an interval.
Okay. Okay, so no breaks, right?
No breaks,
no holes, like a piecewise function like this, not continuous. Okay. So I always think of it, too, as I could draw it and trace it without lifting my pencil, right? So in the context of calculus, the definition for a continuous function, so a function f is said to be continuous at a point x, provided the following two are true. F of a exists, right? So that means I have a y value for my x value, right? So there's a hole. That's kind of like there's a hole, right? F of a wouldn't exist if there was a hole. The limit as x approaches a of f of x exists. How do we know when the limit as x approaches a exists? Okay, broken record time. The limit from the left equals the limit from the right. Then the limit exists. So the limit exists when the limit from the left equals the limit from the right, right? And then the third requirement is that the limit as x approaches a of f of x equals f of a, right? So determine if the following functions are continuous. So I'm going to draw. I couldn't. Is this continuous? No, why not? Has a hole, so which one fails? Which of the three above fails?
Number one.
The limit right here exists because the limit from the left equals the limit from the right. So two is good, but three is not good. Okay, let's draw another one. Is this function continuous? No, what does it fail? Number one, this exists. Every x value exists. Number two and three, because the limit from the left does not equal the limit from the right. I think, David, this is what you were kind of saying. The limit doesn't exist here because of what? There's no y value at the asymptote, therefore. What about this one? Man, I'm an artist today. So obviously all of these I couldn't trace with my pencil. So my non-calculus definition, they all make sense, right? That I can't trace these with my pencil. But we're in calculus class, so we need to know the calculus definition of continuity. No, why?
Number three.
Good. The limit, or f of a exists, it's right here. The limit from the left equals the limit from the right. But the limit from the left and the limit from the right do not equal the functional value. So no on three, right? Okay, what do you guys think about number five? Is this function continuous? No, why not, Kira? Because of the denominator, good. So what is this kind of similar to? Well, we don't really have a picture. So it's not continuous where?
Where it's
whenever the denominator equals 0, right? When the denominator equals 0, it's undefined. So it's discontinuous at x equals 5.
Can you simplify the function
first? You can simplify the function. If you simplify the function, what happens?
It's just going to be x plus
4 or something. So you factor the numerator. So what kind of discontinuity does this mean? So here, the thing is that here I've written an equivalent function. When I factor and cross out, that means that there's a hole there. So there's a hole at x equals 5. Remember, how do we know if there's a vertical asymptote? There's a vertical asymptote if I simplify and then set the denominator equal to 0. Right? So here, because I could simplify and cross it out, that means it's a hole. But if I simplify and cross out and then I set the denominator equal to 0 and I get a value, that tells me there's a vertical asymptote at that point. Here, I'll do another example. Here, I just flipped it. So this equals x minus 5 over x minus 5 times x plus 4, right? Here I simplify, this is a whole, right? If I can simplify numerator to denominator, that means there's a whole. So it would look like this, right? If I didn't have this dot here, that's kind of what it looks like, something like that, right? It doesn't show up on your calculator though, right? But I still have this x plus 4 in the denominator, so x plus 4 equals 0, x equals negative 4 is the vertical asymptote. Right? So we're just kind of going over different types of discontinuity. But this is discontinuous because at x equals 5, because x equals 5, f of 5 does not exist.
So, the original question, there's no asymptote.
So, number 5 is discontinuous at x equals 5 since x equals 5 does not exist. Okay, so that fails the first one. And then I think we're going to have to stop there. So we'll finish this up next class. So 2.4 and 2.5 we finished. So 2.4 I'll make due Monday night, and 2.5 I'll make due Wednesday night. Okay? And I hope to see you guys at the math club later. Cool kids. Still in that video.